This illustration is explaining a situation of photoelectrons going around an ion. Here we are given that a small metal plate of wave function phi and it is kept at a distance d from a singly ionized fixed ion. Here we can simultaneously draw the situation also. If this is a fixed ion and at some distance from the ion, which is given as d, we have kept a small metal plate and a monochromatic light beam is incident on the metal plate and photoelectrons are emitted. So, if radiations fall on it, electrons are emitted from this plate and we are required to find the maximum wavelength of this light beam so that some of the electrons may go around the ion along a circle. For these electrons which are emitted to move around this ion in a circular path, these must have a speed such that the attractive force by the ion on electron will provide the necessary centripetal force for its circular motion. So, here we can write if V is the speed or the maximum speed of ejected electrons. Here, to move in circular path, we use the electrostatic force due to the ion charge on it can be given as 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught E square by D square, and that should be equal to the centripetal force on it, which is mv square by d, as these will be revolving in a circle of radius d if these electrons are ejected tangentially to the plate. So, in this situation, 1d gets cancelled out and we should also use, if we take this as equation 1, we also have, we can write the relation hc by lambda for the wavelength incident on the radiation. This should be equal to work function plus maximum kinetic energy, which we can write as half mv square, as we have taken v the maximum speed, and we can substitute the value of mv square from this expression, which gives hc by lambda is equal to phi plus half, and mv square here can be written as e square by 4 pi epsilon naught d. And on simplifying this, we get the value of lambda, which is the maximum lambda required, or this is the minimum energy required so that the fastest electron will go around the circle. Numerically, this is given as 8 pi epsilon naught h c d divided by e square plus 8 pi epsilon naught phi d. That will be the result of this problem. And this is the value of maximum wavelength or corresponding to minimum energy of radiation for which this will take place.